Well, we're about to find out what the team's strategies are here because we've got about 15 seconds to go. They're just trying to hold themselves in position. They don't want to cross that line early. And the 49er FXs are away in their medal race here in Yair.
And the Japanese 611 are over.
There's the Japanese, there's the flag. And it's the Japanese according to your data.
And they are going back. They've peeled straight off from the bottom of the group. No, there they are. They're straight in shot. So one boat feeling like they were over and appealing back when it was only this boat right in shot.
Okay, we'll see how that went. We'll get confirmation of which boat was over the line early as we watch the Japanese making headway and leading the fleet off the start line. Chika Hitai and Hiroka Itakura currently sitting in sixth in this going into the medal race.
Yeah, you could see their bow being a little bit over the line, I think, so I wouldn't be surprised if they were the ones.
Well, in a moment, if that's the case, we'll see the one of the umpire boats going and waving the OCS flag at them.
And with regard to that, sort of as soon as that Japanese boat's removed, it was the Danish boat that won the start off. In the controlling position against the Kiwis. The Kiwis are about three boats just down to leeward of them, are slightly bow forward, so we can see them identified here now. So in line with the Danish, Maloney and Meach just down to leeward though, so when they come across and tack, they will be on port tack, so you'll see them duck down behind back of them. At the moment, this breeze favouring at this right side, so these boats staying on this longer starboard tack, but also dropping light again. We've got down to about 6 knots, five and a half now. So it is going slightly soft again, and that's where you're seeing the teams very gently moving around the boat, keeping their weight together, and the crews forward of that mast.
Yeah, that's an example of what you're talking about, exactly what you're describing there on the Danish boat. Our overall leaders with the crew crouched down, well forward of the mast.
Just in shot there, you've got Maloney and Meach with the Red Bull symbol just taking that tack, the blue bibs there, taking that tack to clear their air and the go. Yeah. And now the Danish taking that late sort of a loose covering tack.
Yeah, that's a good decision though, you know. If you put them in a tight cover, you don't want to get an attacking duel. So that's not a bad tactics, actually. They just want to keep the control and they don't want to go too far away, just nicely following them, keeping the speed up high, and yeah, don't lose sight of them.
Following them isn't going to win them a gold medal though.
All right, no, you're right. I was a little bit confused about about that,
but right now it's a battle for first and second between the Argentinians and the Swedes. Victoria Travascio and Maria Brantz sailing together for a while now. But on our screen, we're looking at the first and second place boats overall. The Danes and the Kiwis.
And also the Japanese have now been notified, hence not on that leaderboard, so they have been pulled from the race and have continued off towards the left-hand side of the course. So light breeze as they approach up towards this top end of the course. Boat speeds all down to anything from four and a half knots. We're seeing some of the top speeds kind of creeping in at about 5.5 knots when they've got that little bit of pressure.
Yeah, the lead overall constantly changing between the Danes and the Kiwis, Maloney and Meach. They're sort of shifting positions ever so slightly. Occasionally, one goes ahead, the other one goes ahead on the course. So that battle for gold is still very much alive. The Danes still in control, though.
Yeah, it's hard to say at the moment because we're going in a straight line, and it will all depend on the last part, on where we go to the top mark to see how the positions will be. It will depend on where the last puff and wind shift is coming from, because they're separated a little bit in distance. So that will be crucial, the position at the top mark.
Well, the leaders coming into that first top mark, the Swedes and the Danes right behind them. And if our graphic is correct, somewhere we've got the Argentinians coming into the mark as well from a different angle.
Well, interesting the position as the Swedish came across there, and what looked on the lay took that double tack back. This breeze shifting round a little bit. We have Maloney and Meech appearing in the right there of the screen. Good momentum. Danish boat tacky underneath. Very, very tight. You can see the speed difference as the Kiwis just have a little bit more momentum. They'll be looking just to try and keep that bow where it is, but slowly lower it down and gain that speed to roll over the top and put the pressure on the Danish. The Argentinians in a very tight lane there.
Yeah, that's a packed top mark rounding.
But Nace and Runningen of Norway are round that top mark first. We're on board with the Kiwis. Watch the teamwork. And quite a traffic jam up there. The Argentinians slipping in on the inside. Yeah. And the Kiwis getting a boat between themselves and the Danes.
Yeah, they had a great, great mark rounding. They were a little bit above the ley line, giving them free air and being able to go fast, whereas the Danish boat was stuck in traffic, as you said. Cannot explain it better. And was really slowing down because of the boats in front. And that's why the Kiwis have been able to pass them, and now already with quite a lot of distance in front.
And you could see the Kiwis accelerating away once they were round, and the Danes struggling to get that speed up. The Danes currently sitting in fifth with Maloney and Meech in third. That's the battle for gold and silver. But what about bronze? Nace and Runningen of Norway. They started in a bronze medal position, and currently their position in this race keeps them in that bronze medal position.
Currently, as those top two boats stand as well, there's 1 point separating them. So any place movement, and that's why we've seen it constantly changing across that course. Say that extra place either gained by Molly and Meech or lost by Vaz Nielsen and Olsen could shuffle those medal places around.
So we're in a situation where the Danes will really want to overtake the Argentinians, and Maloney and Meech, as they are trying very hard, will want to get ahead of the Norwegians. Now, they've just slipped ahead on this, but let's see as they go downwind how long they stay in that second place. It's snakes and ladders at the moment.
Yeah, it's very exciting. Everybody's quite close together, so it's key to finding the right lane, you know, jibe at the right moment, close to your opponent, or still be in control, but also still be able to go fast, because it's quite some distance that they have to cover. And again, it's really hard to see, especially when they're separated, which side is going to pay off, and they're really making different decisions.
So your lead two boats are these ones with the black kites, so they've gone further out on that track, sailing in towards that left-hand side of the course. And again, the Danish just keeping a nice loose cover on Maloney and Meech, but from looking at the results here, they are squeezing up the places, and it is putting the pressure on the Danish. But with these boats, a little bit of pressure down the middle part of the course. Again, it's going very light, down to some of the lightest we've seen over the last couple of races, down to 5 knots now. Cruise way forward in front of the mast, keeping that kite set, giving as much curl as possible to allow a good bit of depth. The helm's balanced up on that front part of the rack. It's all about speed, keeping this momentum on, minimizing the loss in the jibes. And this is where Kiwi team are set in a nice position. They are running in line. They are the furthest ones out towards this side of the course, giving them a nice run in towards the gate.
And an interesting little battle for fifth and sixth between the two British partnerships. No chances of medals there. I mean, as things stand anyway for Dobson and Tidy, but obviously a battle within the team for fifth and sixth at the moment. But we're watching our leaders, Westra and Netzler of Sweden, out in front. Started the day in seventh place and winning this race, as things stand, would put them in sixth. So they were always out of the medals, and they're out there just to prove themselves.
Yeah, so we're having the final approach towards the gate, and it will be interesting to see how the teams that went to the other side have gained or consolidated.
So not much of a gap between first and second. The Argentinians hot on the tails of the Swedes. Victoria Travascio and Maria Brandt. They won this the World Cup Series event in Gamagori. They're a well-established World Cup Series partnership. Always there or thereabouts. But can they reel in the Swedes in this medal race here in Yeah?
Really difficult. You could see on the previous picture when we zoomed out, was there's the Danish going across in the background. They hit a really big hole in that mid part of the course, and everyone's been able to sail in and around them, and that's just given plenty of breathing space to Maloney and Meach as they took that mark rounding. The Danish jibed in, but noticing as they were coming down that wind, down that last leg, they were a few degrees, 5 to 7 degrees, sailing a higher angle, but slightly slower as well. And that's just sunk them down into that mid part of the course. They hit that hole, and now they're trying to dig their way back up. But that's been catastrophic to their results at the moment.
It certainly has. That hole, as you called it, in the middle of the leg, has cost Nielsen and Olsen their place at the top of the leaderboard. They've now slipped down to silver. And the women at the front of this fleet, Maloney and Meach, are also now top of the leaderboard and have increased. I mean, they've gone from a point behind to 9 points ahead at the top of the leaderboard. So still in it for the Danes. They've still got to claw back a few places to regain that gold medal position. The battle is still on for gold and silver. And what about for bronze? Because Nason Runningen of Norway, who at one point early on in the race were leading, have slipped down to fifth. They're still holding on to bronze, but for how long? Because the Argentinians are closing the gap overall on them. They're down to, there's just a point between the Norwegians and the Argentinians, who are ahead of them. The Argentinians are now battling to get ahead of the Brits and therefore sneak that bronze medal away from the Norwegians.
Yeah, it will be interesting to see how it plays out. I think the Danes, it's a bit sad for them how it went on the downwind. And what you see in these very light conditions is that very often in the middle of the course, there's a little bit less breeze. Cannot really explain it, but very often it's like that. The people that go out to the sides just get this little bit more breeze, a little bit more speed, and that's exactly what happened. Yeah, we can see the New Zealand team going out to the left side. That's where they were also gaining on the downwind, so that's probably why they think it will be more favorable. They will have a little bit more breeze, and they're avoiding the middle where the Danes have lost.
Showing their experience as Olympic silver medalists, Maloney and Meach, both from families with huge sailing pedigrees. Molly Meach, sister of Sam Meach, who won bronze in Rio in the laser. And there we get a good view of where the Norwegian, where the Danes are in relation to the leaders, and they really have slipped back down towards the back of the fleet.
Yeah.
Now, do you think, looking at that, is there any way back for them?
Well, I think they were in a really bad position at the bottom mark, and they need to do something. So I think this is taking risk, and the chances that it will turn out well is relatively low, because we can see that the whole fleet is somehow choosing the left side because they feel that there's a little bit more pressure. So I'm pretty sure that side will pay off. But
So although the Danes look like they were on a more direct, shorter route to that mark, the Kiwis are traveling faster.
Yeah, they are traveling faster, and there's probably just a little bit less pressure on that right side. But it's very patchy today, and you never know what can happen. But at this point, it's a little bit tricky for the Danes to do that. But I also feel that they have not much other options. So if I would be them, I would probably do the same.
Well, there they are. In a short while, we will find out as they come up to that mark. We'll get a proper measure of the separation between the two boats. The Danes, who are the number two crew, really, in Denmark, and actually being coached by one of the number one crew, by Katja Iversen, who's taking time out to do some coaching and help them. And they now tack and head back in towards the mark. You can see the Kiwis at the fast at the top of this shot coming in fast to that mark. The Swedes just tacking as well. Yes, Jenna May Hansen, the other 49er in the Denmark team, has gone to race in the Volvo Ocean Race. So her partner, Katja Iversen, is now helping Nielsen and Olsen with their campaign, which until today had worked pretty well. They won the first two races here in Yair, but do they have the stomach and the fight to get back into this race? And possibly, do they have a little bit of luck? Because that would help big time as well.
Yeah, that would help big time. Yeah, it's gone very, very light. You see that they are going.
Well, there you go. You can see the separation now between the boats, our leading boats, Maloney and Meech, reaching that top mark. The Danes, well, they seem to have almost stopped the Kiwis, though, as they go around that mark. The Danes closing a little bit of distance on them. And actually, this move has worked for the Danes because they have moved back into the lead overall. Look, the colour has changed beside their name to gold. So let's see how they do rounding this mark. Are they going to throw away that slight advantage that they have?
They had a great approach towards the ley line. They were a little bit, just slightly over, with giving them the room to go fast and forcing the others to tack a little bit below and to pinch. And pinching in these conditions, it's really slow. So that's why the Danes just gained some meters and also now gained some places.
But the Argentinians, though, are, again, causing all sorts of trouble to the leaders. They're putting up a great fight, Travascio and Brandt.
Yeah, it'll all come down to this final run. It's going from gold to silver and again switching. So it's very exciting to see what will happen in the last downwind.
So the British boats are round. The Australians are round as well. And we're going to fly forward to follow this battle for gold, silver and bronze nearer the front of the fleet. The Norwegians just gone out of shot there. They're holding bronze and currently sitting in fifth place, I should say. And there are the Danes, right behind the Argentinians.
So the
That's
Danes,
not a
yeah.
good enough position for
they
gold
need to
as
pass
things stand.
Them. Yeah, they need to pass them and they will do everything they can. Because if they will do that, they will secure the gold. And Maloney and Meech, they cannot do a lot because they are in the lead and they need to stay there. And they can just hope for the Danish team not to pass any other boat. But I think, the Danes, they will try to do everything in their power to pass the Argentinians somehow.
Now, in other sports, they've got their technical directors in their ears. They've got all sorts of computers on board helping them work this out. But they're not just having to sail this boat. They're having to think and do the maths as well.
So as we're looking straight at this shot, you've got the Argentinians who are in a fierce battle with the Norwegians again, with 1 point separating the medals. But as you see, they take the jibe there straight away. The Danish jibing on top, putting that cover on, looking for that extra bit of breeze to come through. Not a great jibe from the Danish team. You can see the acceleration come on earlier from the Argentinians. So a nice jibe from the Argentinians. A slightly lower angle they've come out at as well. And with the speed, you can see the angle change between these two boats. Now the Danish boat starts to pick up the pace, but they're sailing a much higher angle. So again, sailing a slightly higher angle increases a bit of speed, but you're sailing a greater distance. So you're trying to find that VMG in between both of that distance and speed. And you can see the gap there. They've got a little bit of speed, but a gap is increasing as they're sailing a much higher distance and a higher angle.
So the Danes need to get in front of the Argentinians to win gold. The Argentinians need to progress up the fleet by a boat in order to win bronze and snatch it from the Norwegians.
And you can see right behind the actual leaderboard on the screen there, the Swedish boat just going out of shot with the blue spinnaker, the green spinnaker in shot, the Argentinian boat. That's the gap they're trying to close, so you can see how tight it is. But the separation now between the Argentinian boat and the Danish boat, it shows that all came down to that jibe. A poor jibe trying to come up, get some speed, get some momentum. And because of that, trying to keep the flow across that rig has made them sail a much higher angle and actually potentially giving it all to the Argentinians. So a great jibe from the Argentinians under pressure. They will jibe in front. There it is with the green spinnaker as they go down towards the gate. The Danish, certainly in that position, will go a little bit further to try and go late into the gate and force any kind of error right into the final section. But still, again, a lot of distance to gain.
And the Danes will have seen Maloney and Meech round that mark and head towards the finish line, and they'll be feeling very frustrated that they can't close in on the Argentinians right now. Wester and Netzler of Sweden around and heading towards the finish line, but we're focusing on this battle between third and fourth, because this could decide the gold medal overall and the bronze as well. The Dutch crew coming in from the right. Annemiek Beckering and Annette Duet.
Yeah,
the Danes around, no interference
like
from there. Yeah. So as things stand, Maloney and Meech will have crossed the finish line by now and claimed gold, because these Argentinians are going to, and in fact, the Argentinians have now been assigned the bronze. We'll see how that goes. But as far as the gold medal is concerned, Maloney and Meech have crossed the line in first place in this race, and that is enough to snatch the gold from the Danes. Wester and Netzler were second in the medal race to take second place. And now the Argentinians, what a race from them. They've kept their cool, they've stayed calm, and they've taken third place in the medal race. Our leaders going into this race, they had a 5-point lead. They've seen that slip away. Nielsen and Olsen of Denmark cross the line in fourth and claim silver here at the World Cup Series in Yeer. The Dutch coming in fifth. And where are the Norwegians? Because they must have really had a terrible final downwind leg to have slipped up on that bronze medal, because they were holding it. They were holding it going into this medal race and held it for much of the race. But then we've seen the Argentinians do enough, it seems, to take bronze.